An Illinois man noticed the sidewalk sinking and then discovered a strange 1840s secret underfoot. But before we start, please make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the notification bell and smash that like button. We really appreciate your continuous support. Out on the sidewalk of Alton, Illinois, Gary Machens is carrying out repairs to his historic property. But while dismantling a stone wall, he spots something unexpected lurking on the other side. Crawling through a hole, Gary discovers a 180-year-old secret concealed beneath the city streets and sets about solving the mystery for good. For months, Gary and his wife Beth had lived in the house completely unaware of this bizarre sight hidden beneath the ground. Yet they'd had to take a closer look after discovering that their sidewalk was beginning to collapse. What the couple found has opened a door into Alton's past and inspired an array of fascinating speculation. Now, historians are weighing in on the mystery, trying to understand the strange secret under the Machens' home. But what exactly did Gary stumble upon that fateful day? And how did a set of crumbling paving stones lead to one of the most astonishing discoveries that the city has ever seen? The people of Alton are certainly no strangers to mystery and intrigue. In fact, the region has been party to weird and sinister secrets since before Europeans arrived in the Americas. As early as the 1200s, perhaps, indigenous people daubed a huge mural on the limestone cliffs close to where the city now stands. The mural depicted a dragon-like creature known as the Piazza Bird, though it was destroyed by quarrying in the 19th century. Despite that, historic accounts of the winged monster have continued to inspire theories and speculation over the years, and today a modern interpretation of the artwork stands near the city, reminding Alton of its oldest mystery. Does the secret discovered by the couple date back to a similarly pre-Columbian time? Or is it something a little more modern? After all, the history of Alton boasts many twists and turns, beginning with its foundation in the early 19th century. Initially established as a trading town, it is located just north of St. Louis, MO, at a point where the Mississippi, Missouri, and Illinois rivers meet. From the beginning, Alton was a place steeped in industry, and even today, it boasts an unusually large amount of paved streets. In fact, it was beneath one such sidewalk that Gary and Beth discovered their own relic from the city's past. But for how long had it been lurking down in the dark? As it turns out, the Machens were far from the first people to venture beneath the streets of Alton. In the years preceding the American Civil War, for example, the city became part of the Underground Railroad, helping to ferry slaves to freedom in the North. And while this clandestine network was not literally subterranean, reports claim that many secret hiding places were constructed under the region's streets. Was it a relic of this harrowing time, then, that the couple discovered below their Alton home? Or could it have been something from later in the war, perhaps when the city became a temporary hiding place for thousands of Union weapons? After all, it's certainly possible that some of these clandestine munitions are still there. In other words, there are a number of fascinating secrets that could have been lurking beneath the couple's property. According to Realtor.com, the house on Langdon Street was purchased by them for $429,000 back in December of 2020. But little did the two know that they would be getting more than they bargained for. With 5 bedrooms and 2.5 baths, the grand clapboard property is situated just a few blocks from the banks of the Mississippi River. And it seems this enviable position has attracted a number of illustrious people over the years. The architect, for example, was none other than Lucas Pfeifenberger, who would go on to become Alton's 25th mayor. Was it Pfeifenberger, perhaps, who left behind a secret for the property's future owners to uncover? Or was it one of his equally distinguished successors? After construction, the Telegraph reports that the house passed to Captain Henry Brueggemann, who became the city's 27th mayor. Then, years later, it was owned by the 49th person to hold the office, Paul Lentz. Considering the building's historic past, then, it's hardly surprising that the Machens discovered something fascinating hiding beneath their new home. Though, what was the secret, and why had they kept it under wraps for so many years? As they settled into the 3,900-square-foot property, they soon realized that there was more than met the eye. According to a British newspaper, the Daily Mail, the couple first suspected that there was a problem when Gary spotted a slope in the sidewalk outside their new home. But local source, the Alton Telegraph, reported that it was actually his wife who initially noticed that something was wrong. Apparently, Beth saw that a section of their sidewalk was emanating dust clouds and appeared to be hollow, and something unexpected happened when Gary took a closer look. Speaking to the Alton Telegraph in April of 2021, she said, "My husband stepped on the bottom step, and it kind of collapsed." Hoping to get to the root of the problem, Gary began to excavate part of the sidewalk, and that's when he noticed the entrance to a tunnel located beneath his property. Speaking to the Alton Telegraph, Beth recalled the bizarre moment when her husband alerted her to the startling discovery. "He called me at work and said, 'You'd better get home. You're not going to believe what I just found,'" Beth recalled. And she was greeted with an incredible sight upon returning home. There at the bottom of a wall bordering their property was a gaping hole leading off into the unknown. According to the reports, the tunnel entrance itself is built from limestone, a material that is found in abundance in the hills surrounding Alton. When Gary and Beth peered inside, they discovered a low arched tunnel lined with brick. The floor, meanwhile, appeared to be covered in rocks and dirt and littered with scraps of wood. At the far end of the tunnel, the Machens spotted a pile of dirt blocking the passageway. Did the mysterious hole extend even further back? Although the couple were unable to excavate any further, the discovery prompted them to delve deeper into the history of their property in search of answers. Mostly, though, local experts seemed perplexed by the Machens' discovery. Gary told local news network Fox 2, St. Louis, in April 2021. According to historians here in the Alton area, the tunnel was put here in around 1840. At that point, though, the trail appears to go cold. According to the Daily Mail, Gary believes that the tunnel was covered over some time in 1895, when the brick surface of Langdon Street was laid. But so far, he has only been able to speculate on what its original use may have been. As it turns out, the space has plenty of odd features that have kept him guessing. Gary pointed out the strange inconsistencies found within the tunnel walls while showing Fox 2 St. Louis' Patrick Clark around. The former asked, "Why is the stair stepped like this? Why is that in there? Do you see the offset in the brick? And if you look along this wall, it turns that way a little bit. Look down along this wall." Gary explained to Patrick that he had consulted with the Landmark Historical Society about his surprising find. Sadly, the organization has not been able to give him any definitive answers, though it had made a few suggestions. So what might this mystery tunnel have been used for? According to Beth, one theory is that the passage was once used for food or ice storage. The temperature inside would have stayed cooler than elsewhere, after all. And this would have created the ideal conditions for preserving perishable goods. Might the members of Alton High Society who once lived in the house have kept their dinner party provisions stashed away safely below? Another idea, Beth told the Alton Telegraph, is that the tunnel might have been used to house a carriage. Interestingly, she has photographic evidence to support this theory in the form of an early 20th century snap. The image was published by the Alton Telegraph and it shows the house not long after it was built. In the photograph, a building which looks like equestrian stables can be seen located beneath the house. It is possible then that the tunnel recently uncovered was connected to this structure in some way. Or is there a more dramatic explanation for this secret passageway? One that encompasses a darker chapter in America's past. Speaking to Fox 2 St. Louis, Gary speculated, "It could have been used for the Underground Railroad. Before the Civil War, you see, Illinois was considered a free state, where the practice of slavery was outlawed. Across the Mississippi from Alton, though, the people of Missouri had yet to follow suit. Slaves from Missouri would often seek shelter in Alton before escaping to freedom on the other side of the river. En route, they were assisted by a network of safe houses and hiding places known as the Underground Railroad." Could it be, then, that Machens had uncovered just one such refuge buried beneath their historic home? There is no proof of that, Gary admitted, but there was a ferry here in the Alton area to the Missouri side, and it's possible it could have been used for that. But whatever the purpose of the tunnel, it's clear that building it was no mean feat. In fact, Gary believes it would have been a large operation involving multiple people. Whatever they built this for, it took a lot of men and a lot of hours, Gary told Fox 2 St. Louis. You know, one guy didn't do this. He later told the Alton Telegraph, someone went to a lot of trouble to build this, only then to block it off. But how exactly did such a significant structure remain hidden beneath the Machens' home for so long? After all, no fewer than three of the city's mayors have lived there over the years. Were they completely oblivious to the fascinating slice of history that lay buried beneath their feet? I don't know if any of them knew about this, Gary told Fox 2 St. Louis. The house was built in 1890. The tunnel is believed to be from 1840, and it was here for 50 years. We've got the maps that go back to 1863, and this house was not there, and there was not another house on the property here. Despite the tunnel's long history, though, it seems nobody is sure exactly what it is built for. Unfortunately, they might also never find out. Although Gary is interested in opening up the structure for tours, he would need assistance with the costs and logistics in order to do so. And in the meantime, he has his sidewalk to think of. For now at least, the secret hideaway beneath Langdon Street is being resealed. Hopefully, it will one day attract the attention of experts who can solve its mysteries once and for all. Like another tunnel found just weeks earlier. This time, the underground structure was located on the other side of the Atlantic, near the Welsh village of Tintern. Tintern is famous for its abbey, which dates back to the 12th century, so the town is not exactly bereft of historic sites. Though workers were left stunned when they stumbled upon a hidden network of tunnels while digging a trench close to the village. According to Western Power Distribution, the company in charge of the operation, the system was not visible on previous maps of the area. Nothing had shown up on any of our drawings or records to indicate that there was anything unusual about this site, Western Power Distribution technician Alan Gore told BBC in March 2021. Shortly after excavation work began, the team made the extraordinary discovery of what they initially thought to be a cave. Soon, though, the group realized that this was a tunnel network, not a cave. Measuring some 4 feet tall, the passageways snake beneath a modern-day footpath and appear to follow the route of a small stream that runs through the valley. Unsure what they had stumbled on, workers stopped their excavations and called in experts to take a closer look. On the advice of the Welsh government, Western Power Distribution halted the project so that archaeologists could conduct a thorough investigation into the mystery tunnels. Believed to date back to the medieval era, the structures may well have some fascinating stories to tell, but according to Gore, it could be years before experts reach any definitive conclusions. So, who built these tunnels beneath the Welsh countryside? Was it monks from Tintern Abbey, perhaps keen to carry out certain clandestine activities away from prying eyes? After all, there are plenty of religious buildings across the country equipped with secret passages and hideaways, and many of them were used to avoid persecution during the 16th century. In other words, hidden tunnels with historic links are nothing new. Back in Alton, locals have been speculating on the true nature of the discovery made beneath the Machens' home. But while some favor the Underground Railroad explanation, there remains little in the way of conclusive proof. In the future, we hope the full story will be revealed.